Hi, I'm Tuomo from Grundium, and today I'm showing you how to use the Grundium Ocus M40 multi-slide scanner. As with the previous systems, the UI is in a browser, so it's web-based, so you don't need any other software to be installed. So we can just log in using our credentials, and then we can choose the team and the device we want to use. And this is exactly the device that I'm going to use today. So I'll just click connect to device. And that opens up the scanner user interface in the microscope mode. And from here, we can open the stage from the UI, or then we can also click the button on the arm. That's different from the previous models. We don't have to access the UI to be able to open the stage. And with the M models, we can also remove the tray, and then we'll just add slides on the tray, four altogether. And then we close the slide lock, so that way the slides won't drop off even though we move around a bit. So they're safe and secure. Then we just slide back the tray. We have now a feature called automatic scan area detection, and we can have that toggled on or off. And then I can start the scan preview. I can do that from the UI, but I can also do that from the save button on the device. So just press here and the scan preview process starts. So we have two separate overview cameras on each side of the main objective. And each of those capture the preview images of two slides on either end of the tray. And that takes around 10 to 15 seconds, and then they pop up on the screen, as we see here. And the gray outline shows the areas set by the automated scan area detection. And as we can see, they're pretty well set. I don't have a lot of improvements to make. If I did, I could just grab any point of the outline and then drag it to the place that I want to have it. But they're pretty nicely done. I have no adjustments to make. And then we can just proceed with scanning. So as you can see here, the scanner estimates the total time for scanning all of the slides. In this case, would be 9.5 minutes. We can also start scanning each individual slide separately. So we can click scan on either any of the slides. And actually, the order that we clicked scan in, it will be the order that the scanner will scan the slides in. One of the new features of the M system is scan profiles. Scan profile is set of configurations that you might want to change often. So that would be, for example, Z-stacking options. So we can Z-stack up to 7 layers. Then there are image enhancements. So basically, if you want to adjust how the images are shown, we can, of course, may want to adjust that based on sample types. So we can adjust that. And then we can have different file name, case name templates. For example, reading the slide label and using that information in the file name. And then, of course, we can also adjust export settings, export locations, and or export file formats. So that's what can be defined within a scan profile. So that's very handy when you, for example, want to export different files, different cases, different locations. You can insert that information into a scan profile, and when you're scanning, just choosing the preferred scan profile. So let's proceed with scanning. So let's scan the slide C. That will take a bit over 1.5 minutes, and we just hit scan. And then the scanner starts moving and taking pictures of the area that we have chosen. One of the nice features of the M system is that you can already view already scanned areas while the device is still scanning. So for example, now we have two different tissue sections here, and this one is already scanned. So while it is still scanning the other one, this one right here, we can already zoom in and view this part with full magnification. So that's going to make viewing the samples easier and faster. And now that the whole slide is scanned, we can just move around in both of the scanned areas and zoom in using our mouse scroll wheel or the preset zoom settings or buttons in the bottom right corner. So just as easy and simple as it was with the previous systems. Just like before, the scanned images are stored in the scanner itself. So the M system has 2 terabytes of storage, so that's going to hold plenty of images. And to access those images, we can just click in the viewer on the menu here. And then we can see that we have a list of cases here. So in the M system, we just don't have a list of images. We have a list of cases and images within those cases. And by default, cases are created every day. But we can, of course, change that. We can rename the cases. We can assign new cases when we're scanning. So that's a lot more flexible and adaptable than with the previous systems. So, for example, let's look at some images from yesterday. And yesterday, these images have been scanned. And I can, of course, just use it just like in the microscope. You just can zoom in and see what the images look like. And one thing to note is that, for example, in these two cases, we can look at the slide label. And we can see that the image name is actually picked up from the label. So we can automatically read the label and then use that to name the file automatically. So that's a good feature. And then we can, of course, also move the images from cases to other cases. So that's easy organization. And we can, of course, also rename case names. So these features provide a lot more easy organization to your image management. Then we can, of course, export certain images. We can export whole cases. And then we can also use export presets to export those images. So, for example, this one is a web download, which means the browser download folder, and the format is SVS. So if I click export here, then they're already exported. So with the M system, the exporting is also faster than it was with the, or is with the Ocus 20 and Ocus 40 systems. And of course, important information is the device storage status. So you can always see it in the device card up here. So you can see that we have 87 images that are taking up 37.5 gigabytes currently. And we have 1700 gigabytes of free storage on the device. So there it is, our new M40 system. If there's anything you missed or have questions about, don't hesitate to reach out and we'll be happy to organize a personalized demo for you with one of our experts. Just reach out through our website and we'll take care of it. Okay, thank you for your attention and I hope you have a good day. Bye.